Hello scholars, welcome back. I hope you all are doing fine at home. Today we are going to start with grade 7 new images, lesson 2, which is a poem, and the title of the poem is On the Grasshopper and Cricket, which is written by John Keats. You all might be having some or the other special experience with nature, and this poem is also related to nature. Whenever you visit a place, you see plants, animals, and some small creatures which are the part of nature, and they enhance the beauty of nature. Now, let us read out something about the poet, that is John Keats. So, I want each one of you to open your book and you can come to page number 11. Now, let us start reading. John Keats was a British poet. He was born in Moorgate, London. At home, John soon developed an interest in literature and history. So, as we read, John Keats was a British poet. He was born in 1795 and he died in 1821. After his parents died, he went to work with a surgeon. John struggled between his medical career and writing ambitions. So, it means that he was working for both the things. He was also working in the medical field as well as he also had interest in the writing thing. But he soon resolved to become a poet instead of a surgeon. In 1816, John's first sonnet, O Solitude, was published in a magazine called The Examiner. Some of his most famous works are I Stood Tiptoe Upon a Little Hill, Sleep and Poetry, and On First Looking into Chapman's Homer. So, as he was working in both the fields, that is the medical field as well as to become a poet, and he finally decided to become a poet instead of a surgeon. He was one of the main figures of the second generation of romantic poets. On the Grasshopper and Cricket was first published in the year 1817. It remains one of the Keats' most loved poems. It has 14 lines, which qualifies it as a sonnet. Every poet has been inspired by nature, and John Keats was no exception. So, John Keats was deeply in love with nature, and he used to write poems related to nature. He was a keen observer of his surroundings, and even the smallest of insects didn't escape his attention and admiration. Now, let us start reading the poem, and you can open page number 12. The poetry of earth is never dead, when all the birds are faint with the hot sun, and hide in cooling trees, a voice will run from hedge to hedge about the new mown mead. So, in these lines, the poet says that the glory and the beauty of earth is same forever, no matter which season it is or what the weather is like. Here, the poet means to say that the songs of nature are never dead. They continue in all the seasons. Then, the poet says that even in the hot summer, when the sun rays make the birds weak and make them to take shelter in the shadow of trees. A voice can be heard. Then, from hedge to hedge. So here, the word hedge means a row of bushes. And the new mown mead, that means a field of grass. So, the poet says that from hedge to hedge, the voice can be heard. Now, let us move forward. That is the grasshopper's. He takes the lead. In summer luxury, he has never done. With his delights, for when tired out with fun, he rests at ease beneath some pleasant weed. So, here the poet reveals whose voice that is, which is heard from hedge to hedge. That is the voice of a grasshopper. The poet says that when everyone is hiding from the heat of the sun, the grasshopper is still delightful. So, the poet means that when it is very hot, the grasshopper still continues to sing and it continuously keeps on hopping here and there. But when it is tired, that means when it is tired of hopping here and there and when it is tired of singing, then it rests beneath some pleasant weed. Here, the word weed means wild plants. So, the grasshopper feels peaceful beneath those weeds. Now, let's move forward. The poetry of earth is ceasing never. On a lone winter evening, when the frost has wrought a silence, from the stove there shrills the cricket's song, in warmth increasing ever, and seems to one in drowsiness half lost, the grasshoppers among some grassy hills. Here, the poet repeats the statement again that the beauty and glory of the earth is same even in the winter. That means the poetry or the songs of nature never end. The poet is telling here that even when the birds are resting in winter, still the poetry of earth or the songs continue. Then the poet refers to a lone frosty evening. He says that it's silence everywhere. Then the poet says that in winter we can hear the sound of a cricket. The cricket makes a sound and one can hear its sound in drowsiness. Here the word drowsiness is a condition when we are half awake and half asleep. So the poet says that we can hear the sound of a cricket even in drowsiness. So, in this chapter, we have learnt that the poetry of earth is never dead. That means the songs of nature continue. We also learnt that the grasshopper symbolizes summer, while the cricket symbolizes the cold winter. The poem is symbolic of faith and hope. The extreme weather conditions symbolize hardships in life. In spite of the extreme weather conditions, there is always someone to create some music and joy, which brings us relief and allows us to continue with our life. That means, through this poem, we have learnt that there are a lot of hardships in life, but we have to continue and we have to keep that hope. Now, let us discuss the question answers given on page number 13. So, the first question is, whose voice do you hear on summer afternoons? Where does he go when he is tired? And the answer is, we hear the grasshopper's voice on summer afternoons. The grasshopper goes to rest under some pleasant weed when he is tired. So, as we read that due to hot sun rays, when the birds hide, we can hear the sound of a grasshopper in the summer afternoons. Now, moving on to question number 2. Which insect takes over from the grasshopper in winter? So, the answer is, the cricket takes over the grasshopper during winter. As we read that the grasshopper comes during the summer and the cricket comes during the winter. Moving on to question number 3. Explain what the speaker means when he says, the poetry of earth is ceasing never. The answer is, by the line that the poetry of earth is ceasing never. The poet means that the song of the nature is never silent. When one of the insects retire, the other is always there to take his place. The grasshopper and the cricket in this case respectively. So, the poet means to say that the songs of nature are never silent. That means they are never ending. And as we saw that the grasshopper comes in summer and the cricket comes in winter. So, the beauty or the poetry or the songs of nature continue in every season. Now, let us discuss question number 4. Why does the cricket's song sound like the grasshopper's? And the answer is, the cricket's song sounds like the grasshopper's because one can hardly tell the difference when they are drowsy during the winter. That means when we are in the condition of drowsiness. So, we can hardly tell the difference that whether it is the sound of a cricket or the grasshopper. Moving on, we have explain these lines with reference to the context. So, let us start with the first one. When all the birds are faint with the hot sun and hide in cooling trees, a voice will run. So, these lines mean that when all the birds are tired during the summer and faint due to the scorching heat of the sun and when they hide in the cooling trees, the voice of the grasshopper can be heard from the meadow. So, as we read that when all the birds hide in the cooling trees due to hot sun, when the summer season is going on, so we can hear a voice and that voice is of the grasshopper. Now, the second one. On a lone winter evening, when the frost has wrought a silence, from the stove there shrills the cricket's song in warmth increasing ever. So, these lines mean that during a chilly winter night, when there is silence all over, one can hear the crickets chirping, which gives a feeling of warmth in the air. So, the poet is telling that in the chilly winter night, when it is too cold, still we can hear the sound of a cricket. I hope you all enjoyed the poem and we learned a lesson that we should never lose hope in any of the conditions. Whether the conditions are very hard, still we should have some hope. Assignments and worksheets are given in the description box. Keep practicing them and we will be meeting in the next video. Till then, stay home, stay safe, keep washing your hands. Thank you.